divide erupted in fire, violent, red, as the last message of the two couriers arced into the sky. The missiles rained like spears down on the land, burning flags and communities alike, destroying all they struck. The history of the West was erased for the second time, thorough and complete, and America slept once more. Hopeville burned, lightless in the night, invisible fires of radiation scorching it from within and without. It is said a man still walked its streets with a tattered jacket, an old world flag etched on the back. He remained there, perhaps as punishment for the scars he left on the wastes, or a reminder of a history he could not forget. For Ulysses, his journey was over. The courier had been the end of his road. As for the courier, she turned her back on her home for the second time and made her way back, navigating the treachery of the divide. Tunnelers and the marked men avoided the lone figure, as if recognizing the courier's right to passage, or out of fear. The courier walked until she stood again upon the edge of the divide, the last road she would walk before the second battle for Hoover Dam. There, beside her feet, was a final package from one courier to another, a footlocker bearing a gift and a message. But that message, it is something for couriers to carry, and for them alone. The lights flickered across the divide, reminders that the old world histories persist and find meaning in the present. It said, war, war never changes. Women do, through the roads they walk. And this road has reached its end.